إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله indeed the most truthful of speech is the book of Allah وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم and the best guidance is the guidance of our beloved messenger محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها and the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent into this religion of ours وكل محدثة بدعة and everything we newly invent into this religion of ours is an innovation وكل بدعة ضلالة and every innovation is misguidance and it leads astray وكل ضلالة في النار and every going astray and every misguidance is in the hellfire ثم أما بعد my dear brothers and sisters in Islam we again seek refuge with Allah اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من البرص والجنون والجذام ومن سيء الأسقام we seek refuge with Allah from leprosy from madness from degenerative diseases and from every evil and harmful illness and sickness. We're definitely in our trying times and there's nothing as powerful as the adhkar and the ad'iyah, the remembrances and the supplications of the morning and the evening to help gain us protection from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are vital times to especially spend our times not being lazy but memorizing these du'a and adhkar that we can work them into our daily lives morning and evening. This is where we get protection and the help and aid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So let me remind myself and you because reminding benefits to believers as Allah said وَذَكِّرْ فَإِنَّ الذِّكْرَ تَنْفَعَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ with the statement of Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawziyyah rahimahullah where he said if you could hear the sounds of the pens of the angels writing your name amongst those who remember Allah, you would die out of joy. And subhanAllah, what a great ni'mah, a great blessing that would be to have our names written down by the angels for remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, especially in the mornings and in the evenings. And this is something, again, which of course Allah has full knowledge of, but this will be a witness for us on the day of resurrection, inshaAllah. My brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ ذِكْرًا كَثِيرًا وَسَبِّحُوهُ بُكْرَةً وَأَصِيلًا Allah said, what means, O you who have believed, remember Allah with much remembrance and exalt Him morning and afternoon. ثُمَّ قَالَ اللَّهُ And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He also said, فَاصْبِرْ عَلَى مَا يَقُولُونَ وَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ قَبْلَ طُلُوعِ الشَّمْسِ وَقَبْلَ الْغُرُوبِ And Allah said in Surah Qaf, what means, So be patient, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, over what they say and exalt Allah with praise of your Lord before the rising of the sun and before its setting. And to wrap just these reminders up of how beneficial these times are of morning and evening, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, وَذْكُرْ رَبَّكَ كَثِيرًا وَسَبِّحْ بِالْعَشِيِّ وَالْإِبْكَارِ And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, And remember your Lord much and exalt Him with much praise in the evening and the morning. So we need to memorize them. And there's a few of them, but they won't take more than 10, 15 minutes of your morning and evening time. Again, by morning, the majority of the scholars will say this is after Fajr, prayer and the likes before sunrise. Some have said that it's okay if it's after sunrise. And for evening, we mean after Asr, before sunset. And some of the scholars permitted and said it was okay for it to be after Maghrib as well. So, Al-Amr Wasi', inshallah, there's a wide scope here. The important thing, let's make sure we're saying these morning and evening so that we get the protection of Allah. You can find these to print on www.icomantika.org. On the website in the upper left hand corner with the adhkar and ad'iyah for the morning and the evening inshallah. So today's is a very powerful statement. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam he said man qala hina yasma'u an-nida' raditu billahi rabba wa bi muhammadin rasula wa bil islam deena ghufira lahu dhanbuh The Prophet ﷺ, he said in this hadith is in Sahih Muslim, whoever says when he hears the nada, the call to prayer, the adhan, I am pleased with Allah as a Lord, Muhammad as a messenger, and Islam as a religion, then his sins, his minor sins, will be forgiven. As we know, for the major sins, you must make tawbah, sincere repentance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we mention this because this phrase, we're going to see why it's chosen for the morning and the evening, but saying it after you hear the adhan is not something people know. It's a forgotten sunnah. And you can revive the sunnah, and everyone who you remind of this, who does it after you, you'll get a reward without decreasing their reward for following this sunnah. That after you hear the adhan, you don't just say, Allahumma rabba hadhihi da'wat al-tamma wa salat al-qa'ima, ati Muhammadan al-wasilata wal-fadila wa ba'athu maqaman mahmudan al-ladhi wa'atta. This is the one we all know and the one we always say, and many don't know or they neglect saying Radeetu billahi Rabba wa bi Muhammadin Rasula wa bil Islami Deena. So inshallah we can bring that to be revived as a sunnah of our beloved Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Thawban, he reported that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, ما من عبد مسلم يقول حين يصبح وحين يمسي ثلاث مرات رضيت بالله ربا وبالإسلام دينا وبمحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم نبيا إلا كان حقا على الله أن يرضيه يوم القيامة. This hadith, which is great as is Hassan by Sheikh Ibn Baz rahimahullah, may Allah have mercy on him, we'll find that Sheikh Albani, specifically on this one, he had graded it as da'if. But many of the muhaddithin, the scholars of hadith, did give this hadith a grade of hasan. So it is acceptable and we should take it and apply it, inshallah. Thawban, he reported that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there is no Muslim servant of Allah that says when entering the morning and entering the evening three times in each time of the day, morning and evening, رَضِيتُ بِاللَّهِ رَبَّا وَبِالْإِسْلَامِ دِينَا وَبِمُحَمَّدِ النَّبِيَّ صلى الله عليه وسلم. There's no Muslim who says when entering the morning and entering the evening three times, I am pleased with Allah as a Lord, Islam as a religion, and Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم as a prophet, except that it will be a duty upon Allah to please him or her on the day of resurrection to make them content, to protect them, inshallah. Look at the immense amount of reward that you would earn by just saying this, of course, and believing it. And we're going to break down each phrase very quickly, inshallah. Just to complete what's on the screen in front of you, and again, you can print this, inshallah, put it on your fridge or whatever and memorize it. One of the companions of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who used to be in Africa, he said, سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول من قال إذا أصبح رضيت بالله ربا وبالإسلام دينا وبمحمد النبي فأنا الزعيم لأخذن بيده حتى أدخله الجنة. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, or he was heard to have say, whoever says in the morning, I am pleased with Allah as the Lord, Islam as the religion, and with Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as the prophet, then I am a guarantor that I will indeed definitely take him by his hand until I enter him into Jannah, into paradise. And this hadith is established, it's thabit, and Shaykh al-Albani, he placed it in al-Silsala al-Hadith al-Sahiha, in his collection of Sahih and authentic hadith. So we see this proof in front of us, whether to say it once in the morning, there's also a narration that mentions the evening, or the one where the three times in the morning and the evening are mentioned, there is an ample amount of blessings to earn from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by saying this phrase. So in a nutshell, when we say this phrase, what are we hearing, inshallah, or what are we saying? The first phrase is رَضِيتُ بِاللَّهِ رَبَّ, I am pleased with Allah as my Lord. And we should mention that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, ذَاقَ طَعْمَ الْإِيمَانِ مَنْ رَضِيَ بِاللَّهِ رَبَّ وَبِالْإِسْلَامِ دِينَ وَبِمُحَمَّدٍ رَسُولًا. That the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said in authentic hadith in Sahih Muslim, the sweetness of Iman has been tasted by he whoever is pleased with Allah as his Lord, Islam as his religion, and Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as his messenger. So this is the way to taste the sweetness of faith. So being pleased with Allah as your Lord, being pleased with his lilahiyya, yani meaning the one that Allah is the only one that we worship, that you love and only want what Allah, that you love and you only want Allah as your Lord, to only worship and rely on him and none other, that you're pleased with his rububiyya, that you know clearly and wholeheartedly that Allah is the owner and the creator of the heavens and the earth and all that is in between, with no fatigue, no need to rest, no labor, no need for food to keep him going. He could have done it in a second, but he chose 6 days because in his wisdom, that's what he chose. So we are pleased with Allah, with all that he decrees. If you're pleased with Allah as your Lord, you're pleased with everything he decrees. And this is part of Iman, that you believe in al-Qadr, khayrihi wa sharrih, the good of it and the bad of it. Whatever Allah has pre-decreed, we accept it. And what he has happened and what yani Allah wants is better for us, even though our minds or our hearts are yearning, are wishing maybe for something else. Whatever Allah wants, then we know that is what is best for us. Al-Aini, he said in his explanation of Abu Dawood regarding the statement of Allah's Messenger, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I am pleased with Allah as the Lord. He said, this means I am convinced by him. He is sufficient for me. Hasbi Allah. Allah is enough for me. And I do not require anyone along with him. Then, wa raditu bi Muhammad al-Nabiyya aw Rasula, and I'm pleased with his, as with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as his prophet and as his messenger. This includes having perfect obedience to him, completely submitting to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whereby the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the first and foremost to a person than his own self. So he does not take guidance except from the speech of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He does not turn to judgment except to the rules and the laws of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and so forth. He's not pleased with anyone or anything else over that of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In Surah Al-Ahzab, we see the ayah. Allah says, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرَ وَذَكَرَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا. Allah says, what means, indeed in the Messenger of Allah, يعني محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم, you have a good example to follow for him who hopes in meeting with Allah and the last day and remembers Allah much. Regarding the Messenger saying, وَبِمُحَمَّدٍ نَبِيَّ أَوْ رَسُولَ صلى الله عليه وسلم, he means that I am content with the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم as a messenger to me and all of the Muslims and all of mankind. Yani, he is the one I want to be like. He is the one I want to follow. I want to look and dress like him. I want to be devout like him. However, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam did things is how I want to do it. How he prayed, I want to pray. And this was a command. Sallu kama ra'aytumuni usalli. How he did hajj, I want to make hajj. Again, it was a command. Khudu anni manasikakum wa khudu minni manasikakum. How he was with his neighbors is how we should be. He was kind, he was gentle, he was gracious, he was giving, he was always looking out for them. This is how we should be. He is the one we should follow, not nobody else. Not some actor or musician or actress or athlete or whatever it may be. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If you are truly pleased with him as your prophet and messenger, then you leave off what he commanded you to leave off. Especially those things that differentiate us Muslims, like he wanted us to be differentiated. This is how you show love for him. If you truly are pleased with him as your messenger and the seal of all prophets, then you must take what he gave and leave off what he commanded us to leave off. And Allah instructed this, مَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. Allah instructed us with this saying, what means, and whatever the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam gives you, take it, and whatever he prohibits you from, stay away from it. And raditu bil islami deena, and being pleased with Islam as his deen, as his religion. As for being pleased with the deen, this yani, so if the deen says something or gives a ruling or commands or prohibits something, then a person should be completely pleased with it, even if it opposes what you and your desires are, even if it opposes a statement of the one whom one blindly follows, or his sheikh, or his sect, or whatever it may be. This is where all people desert you except the ghuraba, and we'll find out who the ghuraba are. So being pleased with Islam as the deen, meaning that's what we follow, even above our own thoughts, even above intellect, even above whims and desires, etc. The ghuraba are the strangers. Abdullah, he narrates that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Inna al-Islam bada'a gharib wa sayaudu ghariba fatubu lil ghuraba." The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said in this authentic hadith in the Sunan of Ibn Majah, he said, Islam began as something strange. Tawheed was not something the people knew. They were worshipping idols. They were worshipping statues. They didn't want anything to do with worshipping one Lord, subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They just wanted to worship what they were upon and what their forefathers were upon. And it's going to go back to being something strange. In this case, we have some more clarity. So glad tidings be to the strangers. These strangers, without a doubt, are those who hold on to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who live their life according to the Quran and the sunnah as lived and understood by the sahaba, the companions radiyallahu anhum wa radahum. These are the strangers. Why? Because we're even in a time where you see a person doing something that has a basis in the sunnah. They're doing something in their prayer that has an authentic proof from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the majority of the people will be saying, what is he doing? What is this person doing? I've never seen that before. When in actuality, he's doing a sunnah, but we've left it off. This is why we need to revive the sunnah of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and memorize the different ways he did things so that we don't ever accuse someone of following other than that. So these are the strangers, the ones who hold on to tawheed, who hold on to the correct aqeedah, who hold on to the sunnah, because those people really, in reality, are a very little group who will sacrifice their thoughts, their desires, their whims, their intellect, their family being happy with them, whatever it be, just to hold on to the deen the way it was revealed. Allah said, "Inna deena 'inda Allahi al-Islam," that the religion with Allah is al-Islam. This is the only religion Allah will accept after the advent of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, after the coming of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Our deen, its beauty is that we follow it the way it was revealed, because it was revealed for all times and all places, complete, without error, with an explanation for everything. Yet this is where we implode our deen and destroy ourselves and mock Allah and mock His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam and mock the Quran and the Sunnah. You may say, how or who would do this? We do it because we use our intellect, our opinions, our desires, our thoughts to make our deen fit around our lifestyle and make it a 2020 thing or whatever it may be. وَلَعَيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. We seek refuge with Allah from this. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, regarding this statement, وَرَضِيتُ بِالْإِسْلَامِ دِينَ, that I'm pleased with Islam, al-Islam as my religion, it means that I'm content with Islam as my religion, as my way of life. I do not desire any other way than al-Islam, and I do not accept that which is in disagreement with the Sharia of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Meaning, I only accept what agrees with the Sharia of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and I do not desire other than Islam as a deen. Al-Aini, he continued in his explanation, saying that if it is said what is the intent of saying a deen, as a deen, as a religion, he said, I go back to the meaning tawheed, because of the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمَن يَبْتَغِي غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينَ فَلَن يُقْبَلَ مِنْهُ وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. That Allah said what means, and whoever seeks a religion other than al-Islam, it will never be accepted of him, and in the hereafter, he will be one of the losers. Again, this refers to tawheed. My brothers and sisters in Islam, remember the statement of Allah, اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. That Allah said in Surah Al-Ma'idah, this day, what means this day, I have perfected your religion for you and completed my favor upon you and have chosen for you al-Islam as your religion, the Islam that Allah revealed to His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Islam that His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam delivered and taught us as lived and understood by the companions radiallahu anhum wa radahum. Hearing all of this, how can we downplay our great and perfect Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who deserves all worship and praise, and whose qadr, His decree, is the best whether we think of it or not? How can you downplay the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that He sent, rahmatan lil alameen, as a mercy to mankind, to guide us on the straight path, out of darkness into light, a path that would end us in Jahannam, a path that would end us in Jannah, in the gardens of paradise, and not in Jahannam, not in the hellfire. Who there is no one better to be like than Him, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and no one better to emulate than Him, the best of mankind. How can you downplay the deen He sent, al-Islam, His deen, not our deen, His deen, not your deen, to make up, to contort, to twist, or to suit yourself? So my brothers and sisters in Islam, we should be proud of our deen and following it the way it was revealed. And we should teach our children to be proud of it, not having to hide to say that they're Muslim or whatever it may be. We should be proud that Allah guided us to this. Alhamdulillah, alladhi hadana lihada, wa ma kunna linahtadiya lawla an hadana Allah. Praise be to Allah who guided us to this. And without His guidance, we would have sure indeed been astray. Do not let anything distort you or divert you from this. Allahu Akbar. We are Muslim. Allah is our Lord. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is our messenger. Islam is our deen. We are not to taint it, we're to love it, and Allah will love you. So do not insult Allah or His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam by doing exactly what they forbade, by imitating those who we are not supposed to imitate from the disbelievers. May Allah help us, my dear brothers and sisters. May Allah make us of those who are pleased with Allah as our Lord, al-Islam as our religion and way of life, and with Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as our prophet and messenger and the final messenger and prophet that Allah will send with the final message, the Quran, the book of Allah, and the sunnah of the messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Again, the sunnah is wahi, it is revelation, as Allah said, وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَى, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not speak of his own vain desires and just say, hey, I think praying should be like this. It was a wahi, it was a revelation revealed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, this is such an easy thing for the tongue to say. Radeetu billahi rabba, I am pleased with Allah as my Lord. Wa bil islami deena, and with al-Islam as my religion. Wa bi Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam nabiyya, and with Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as my messenger and prophet. May Allah make us of those who truly mean this and believe it in our hearts and live upon it. And may He make us successful inshaAllah and protect us through these adhkar in the morning and the evening. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik, wa ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.